Hi guys, welcome back. So last night I said I expect the market to continue dropping and it went down quite strong today. It gapped down the support and continue going south. If we look at the 5 minutes chart, in the morning it was like a flood. Everything was dropping. But luckily, everything also bounced back up pretty fast. There were some serious buying the dip going on there. So in the end, it closed above the opening price to be a green candle with a little spike of volume, also a green bar. So that is a little bit good sign there. But even though with a dramatic scene today, I am still concerned about the fear and greed index. The fact that it can still stay to be greedy after such a day. In the morning, it dropped a little bit to be neutral, and then in the afternoon, right back to greed. So a lot of people buy the dip in the morning, and I assume there were both retail investors and institutions. We should expect the rebounds from here, but I won't consider the correction to be over until it passed the all-time high, or it bounced back up quickly with spike of volume, okay? So as long as we are prepared for further dropping, then there's no need to panic. I did not touch at all my long-term position, just to let you know. My account was down about $200,000 these few days. It's more than the whole month of profit for me last month. But dropping, it's part of the game in the stock market. No one can time it perfectly. So that's why when there's market correction, I usually just don't open my app unless I need to make transaction and adjust my portfolio. And the market dropping is part of the game of the stock market. Things only rise when there is drop. So there is absolutely no point to ask yourself questions like, why did I something something? Or why didn't I something something? There is absolutely no point to ask yourself these kind of questions because it only makes you weaker. And I believe in the stock market, the only way to win is to have a strong mind, a strong heart, to be able to tolerate this kind of movement in the market. It's normal. So when there are days like this, you can just close the app and go do something else, take a run or take a walk. Because it's pointless to keep looking at the price action or panic selling. The least thing you can do is to panic. As long as we are confident about our long-term position, as we bought these stocks because we believe in the company's future, right? So there is no point to stare at the short-term price action at this point. Now we look at Apple. It has reached a strong support of 122, and there were strong buying the dip movements with the big spike of volume that we have not seen for at least 1 or 2 months, the buying volume. If we open this today, in the morning, the share price dropped quite steep as well, but at the same time, the buy-in action was also quite strong. In the afternoon, it's gone up back to the green zone. So it looks like institutions were here trying to save the market, save the index. So that's some good sign. Facebook were looking quite strong, still managed to stay up 2%. Look at the 5 minutes chart. The buy-in action was much more steep than the selling action. So that looks quite bullish for Facebook. It's clear that someone is trying to save the FANG stocks to protect the index. We'll see if they succeed. Now let's look at our stocks. First, our baby NIO. I said that I expect the support of 49 to be holding quite strong, but I guess nothing can fight a market like this today. So it gapped down below and went south quite fast in the morning and touched the next support at around 40 to 41 and bounced back up quickly and closed at exactly 49. So NIO was quite influenced, just like Xpeng and Li Auto, by the EV giant of Tesla. Let's see Tesla. So Tesla also broke a few supports to come back down to 610 today. That was some big dropping for a giant company like this. So of course, if Tesla crashed, it would affect all the EV players. But as expected, we know someone would be here catching the falling knife for Tesla. First of all, ARK Invest, who is the most bullish on Tesla, had been buying Tesla recently every time it dropped. And today, when Tesla dropped to 13%, ARK Invest has also said they bought a lot, but they didn't say how much. And also, other big guy like Gary Black, didn't he just said that he was bearish on Tesla? And it doesn't matter because they can change their mind anytime. So he tweeted in the morning that he's long on Tesla again. It doesn't matter what they think because they can change their mind anytime. And if we follow the opinion of the big guys, the ones who would get burned would be, of course, the retail investors. But it doesn't matter. As long as the Tesla drama can be over, so will our baby Neo recover from the drama. Now, we expect it to bounce back quickly or consolidate a little bit before, because these few days might just happen to be the last wash sale before the next catalyst, such as the earning, such as the factory, such as the international expansion, and so on. But it does look like it's the last wash sale before the next move. So if you had cut the falling knife, just hold on to it, okay? Next, it's our EH. EH also had reached a strong support and it gapped down to open today, continue dropping and then also rebound and come back green. And it was dropping without volume because a lot of the selling pressure was already done before. And right now you can see, and that's why right now we can see much less people are selling now. This is a good chance to buy the dip. So if you want to average down or open this position, today was also a good chance. Next, our LKCO. So last night I said that I expected after such a bull run up, it needs to have wash sell to create panic for people to cut loss here and take profit here. Now we look at LKCO in the morning. The drop was quite steep, right? But as well as the buying force, someone was buying the dip and makes it bounce back up quite quickly. As I said yesterday, I do expect after such a huge run up to have a hard wash sell in order to drive people to take profit here and cut loss here. And by doing so, we need to have fear. And what is better fear than flooding down so quickly, right? So I'm not surprised to see some panic sell going on in the morning. And we know who catch the falling knives. And because we were well prepared for fear to be created here. So that's why in our group chat this morning, I didn't see panicking, but rather buying the dip happening. So I felt quite proud. And then there were also good news today. It's that LKCO had successfully finished raising fund of $100 million by selling the shares to institutions at the cost of $2.08. So $2.08. It's around here, right? And because we bought in since it was 60 something cents and continue averaging up around $1.90 and average up a bit more at $2. So we should be still at the average price of $1 something, which is still much lower than the cost of institutions to be 2.08. So I don't think we need to worry about this or panic right now, but rather just sit tight and watch the roller coaster. And also, this is the purchase history from Julie of LKCO. They first bought 12 million at the price of $6 per share at first, and then they continue adding 42 million at the price of $1.95 per share. So even the cost for Jilly was significantly higher than our cost, right? So if Jilly is not worried about it, why should we be worried about that? So that is why I insist I am ready to do nothing for the roller coaster, okay? Now JKS was also a roller coaster today. It gapped down below to open, continue driving it down fast, and then bounce back up quickly, just like others. Now it's beaten down also by the whole solar sector, but it might have reached the limit and would more likely bounce back up from here on. We might have had our golden dip because it might just be the last wash sale before the next earning, before the next catalyst. We should have had some good news that's not reflected on the share price yet. Okay, and today, okay, and if you wonder what I have done today, is that I bought a lot of call options on Huami today. I also said this in the Discord in the morning. I said if you still have cash or if you're holding the FANG stock, I would change it to Huami right now, because especially when I'm not sure about the whole market situation right now, because the whole market situation can drive down every single stocks. And after the first wave down, the stronger ones would stay up first. And at this point, I'm very bullish on Huami. With my heavy position on NIO, EH, and LKCO, these three are currently more driven by the whole market and also the sector. But Huami is what I believe I can add on regardless of the market situation right now. I feel more safe. As I continuously said in the past, that Huami is the stock that I would hold on tight at any market correction or even market crash. Especially, I analyze what's gonna happen to them in the near future. I get more and more bullish on Huami as well. So today, I bought a lot of call option on Huami, long-term call option at the strike price of 35. And today it dropped to 15. And 35 was the highest strike price in the whole option chain. Otherwise, if they have higher price, I might have lifted up my strike price as well. So this is how much I'm bullish on Huami. I think it will be exploding in the near future, and it might be affected by the whole market, but not completely. So that's why I kept on adding the option call for Huami. Now, if you're not used to option, I do think adding share is much more safe than adding options. You don't need to follow what I do because you don't know when I will sell it. Okay? I didn't even plan to open up my stock app today because there was such a crazy correction, but I set the automatic order before to buy this option at the price of 2.5, and then it dropped to that point and then it went through. I saw that and I continue adding after. I'm quite bullish on Huami and I was taking advantage of the big drop today. Now, if you have been following my channel, you know that I have been suggesting Huami at the price around 12 to 13, and I was buying it at the price around 11 to 12. And I said before that even though it's $30, it's still considered cheap and undervalued. And I think even after such a big run up recently, I still think it's only the beginning. Once it starts to wake up, I think it will be explosive and we need to fasten our seatbelt. Okay? Now before I end, I also want to tell you that I opened a position on a new stock named Yunji, ticker symbol YJ. I have not done an in-depth analysis video on this yet, but I just opened the position recently. It's a social e-commerce platform targeting third and fourth tier city housewife. You can kind of understand it as a Pinduoduo PDD, but with membership. So people sell things to their friends. So we know that recently PDD has been growing quite strong because of the anti-probe of the Chinese government on Alibaba to not allow them to use the strategy of either or anymore. So that's why it would benefit Pinduoduo. So it had been creating this huge jump up recently. But as of right now, I wouldn't go chase to Pinduoduo anymore, but rather I would go into Yunji right now, because there might be a possibility that it can start small and continue growing, because this social e-commerce is still a new thing, a new trend that they are exploring right now. So we'll see. And I just see this as a new trend, and right now it's still quite new. The market cap has been down because the share price has been beaten down since the IPO. It has yet to prove their growth with earning. I have opened the position and based on more research, I will see how much I continue to average up or down. Now that's it for today. I hope you did not panic today for the market correction. It's a very necessary correction after such a crazy jump up. It's part of the game, and how we handle it will decide whether we can win in the stock market. Okay? And if you have enjoyed this video, please give me a big, big like and write me a great comment. And I will see you tomorrow. That's it, guys. Hope you can find my videos helpful. Make sure you subscribe to my channel and give me a big like. Thank you.